Hi, my name is Arjan Speksnijder. I'm pre-sales engineer for the Webex WFO suite. And in this recorded video, I will show you the value of our Webex WFO quality management features. And I will not only show you the standard quality monitoring features, but I will also show you the added value of our analytics module to the quality management process. But first, let's take a look how we can search and replay interactions, recorded interactions. Because, of course, as each quality management process, it starts with recording the calls. Not only calls, you can we can also import the chats, your emails, maybe your messaging channels like WhatsApp or other messaging channels. We can all include it in the Webex WFO. Of course, all calls will be automatically synchronized with the Webex CC because that's just fully integrated. And for the other types of media, we can integrate it from other sources if that's that is needed. And once all the interactions are stored in our Webex WFO database, we can easily search and replay all those interactions using our recording search feature. And the recording search feature is just easy to use. You can add a filter based on all the data which is available and attached to the different types of interactions, and you can create your own search filter. And once you apply the search filter, you will get a list of all interactions matching the search criteria you put into the filter. But if you're a quality evaluator, you probably don't want to spend a lot of time with searching and selecting the interactions you want to use in your evaluation process. And for that, we have our contact queue. Our contact queue is a predefined list of interactions based on a preset selection rule you have defined by yourself. Now, let's assume you recently discovered that your handling times are being increased, and you want to dive into that, and you want to analyze the long calls of your agents. So in that case, you can set up a rule. Let's say, give me the three longest calls for each of my team members per day, and those calls then will be automatically be selected by the system and presented to me in my contact queue. And you can even have those interactions being pre-assigned to evaluators, so that each evaluator has his own portion and maybe his own team members to evaluate without having to select it, anything manually. And then the next thing, of course, if I want to redo my evaluation, I only have to go into my contact queue and select the interactions and start evaluating. And as you see right now, I double-clicked on one of the interactions, which will open my what we call the media player. And the media player is a one single view containing all information which is relevant for me as a quality evaluator to do my evaluation. It has, of course, an evaluation form where I can do my actual scoring based on the questions and the sections and the answers I have defined myself, because those forms you can define yourself using an easy evaluation form wizard. And you can define as many forms as you want, so that you can have forms for each department, or maybe for the different types of evaluations you want to do. Maybe you have different types of forms. And once you have attached a form to an interaction, that you, of course, you can do it also automatically with using the contact queue. You can not only select the call, but you can also include the right evaluation form and attach it to that interaction. And once it's connected to the interaction, you can use it for doing your evaluation and your scoring. On the right top part, you will see, let me scroll a little bit further down so you can see the screen. You can see a synchronized screen recording, because with Webex WFO, we're not only able to record the calls, we can also record your screen, the screen of the agent, so that you will have synchronized screen recording, and you can see what was my agent doing during the call. And for example, in this time, I can see there's some silence. It's for me very valuable to see what was my agent doing during the silence period. And maybe you can identify some training needs because he doesn't know how to use the systems, or maybe you can identify some broken processes or slow systems, which is causing unnecessary delay and increased handling times because the agent has to wait till the systems are responding. And if you know what's happening, you can address the issue, you can have it fixed, and then of course you can reduce the handling times due to better performing systems. At the last part of the media player, you'll see all relevant data attached to these interactions. What type of interaction is it? In this case, it's a call, and I can see which number has been called, the number of the caller, all types of metadata I can see in this part, and it's giving me more context to the call. But if I scroll further down, I see a container called metadata. This is very interesting. Why? I'll tell you. With the metadata, you can define your own customized metadata fields and have them filled with data from other external systems. Maybe you can include a link to your Salesforce pages, to the customer's pages, or the case in Salesforce. Maybe you can put in a survey score if you sent out a customer survey after the interaction, and you can include the scores from a third-party system and have it imported in the WebEx WFO, so that you have even more context to this call than the data you've already have. And of course, you can use this metadata fields to even better selection criteria, or being able to have better insights by combining the metadata with your search results or your evaluation results. And for example, if you include a sales value in the metadata, you can relate, as you can see here, this is this example, there's a monetary value. This can be your sales value. You can relate your successful sales to the evaluation scores and to the calls which were being successful, and you can learn from that calls and use this as a coaching material for other agents to get better in sales also. So as you can see, it's just adding a lot of value because you can add additional data, additional context to this call. And what I'm showing you right now is what we call our default WebEx WFO quality management features. So this is default out of the box for WebEx WFO. But let me show you what will happen if we add our optional analytics model to the WebEx WFO. In this case, as you can see, it is offering me even more context, even more information. Of course, I have still the same data as I saw in my prior interaction. I have still my metadata, my evaluation form, my synchronized screen capture. But now, as you can see, I have also a fully transcribed transcription of my voice conversation. And this will help me with understanding this call much more faster, because I can just scroll through the transcript, I can read through it, and I can jump right into that part of the call I'm interested in without having to listen to it, to scroll forward, backwards. And this will save me a lot of time, and it will enable me to go right into the topic of interest. And I can do much more. I can analyze much more calls than we used to with the standard without analytics, because in that case I have to search and scroll through the voice conversation. I don't have to do this with using the analytics. I can just dive right into the right part of the call. Another thing what analytics is adding to the media player is what we call our phrase hits, as you can see. And this, those phrase hits are phrases you can define. Our analytics is based on what we call categories and phrases. And with categories are topics you want to focus on. As you can see here, for example, unsuccessful sales, sales opportunities, repeat calls. So these are topics of interest. And phrases are sentences, keywords, which very likely are related to the topic. So let me see an example. If I open Phrase Manager in here, I have my, and if I want to focus on account management related interactions, I can create a category called account management and then put one or more phrases to that category, which most likely being used in calls or interactions related to an account management issue, like I recently moved, I changed my address, what is your new address? So all those phrases can be defined in a category, and then based on the category, you can search and select the interactions very, very fast. And of course, you can report on all those categories and phrases. But it will also help me in my interaction evaluation, because each time a phrase has been recognized in an interaction, it will be tagged, as you can see, in a call, and I can filter on it. So let's say if I want to focus on unsuccessful sales in this call, I can filter my phrases to the unsuccessful phrase category. It will highlight all phrases related to this category, and this, there's one phrase that is the one of my colleagues. So that is the phrase attached to the unsuccessful sales category. And if I click on it, you will see I will jump right into the part where this phrase is being said. So again, it will help me in diving right into that part of the conversation, which is interesting for me. So if you're on a call of 20 minutes, you don't have to listen to all 20 minutes and scroll forward and backwards, but you can dive right into the part, and it will save you very, very much time in analyzing and going right to the point of interest. But with our analytics, it's adding even more value, because with the analytics we can also do what we call transcription search. This means let's assume in the recent quality evaluations I discovered that in some calls the keywords crazy is being used, which I don't like and which I don't want and which I don't expect in my customer service calls. So this is a point of interest for me, and I want to do more deep dive on those calls. So for me now it's very easy. I just type in my keywords I want to focus on, press the search button, and it will now present me a list of interactions containing the keywords I put in my search criteria. And as you can see, all those are hyperlinked. I can just click on the hyperlink and I can dive right into the call, and I can of course again use my phrase hits if I want to, in this case negative sentiment, and I can see it's ridiculous and crazy. Oh well, here it is, here's my crazy sentence. So again, very powerful, very effective for analyzing and doing a deep dive on a typical subject. And by the way, what you can see in here, there's another swim lane in this this media player view. It's called desktop. That's because with our analytics add-on, you're not only getting the transcriptions and the text analytics and the phrase detections, but with also you can also apply our desktop analytics tool, which will monitor the application usage of your agents. So you can monitor which web pages are being used during the call, which applications will be used for how long, and so it will give you an extra dimension and additional context when analyzing this call. And once You've analyzed all those calls, you've evaluated the calls, you've done a lot of scorings. Then, of course, you have to do something with all those scorings. You have to be able to report on it, to summarize it, to see trends and get insights out of all those evaluations. And for that, we have our built-in Data Explorer. With Data Explorer, you can build your own personalized dashboards. Yes, we will provide a number of standard dashboards, but the most powerful part is that you can build those yourself. And as you can see, this is just an example. You can add all types of information in some dashboard. You can put in tables with maybe this, in this case, the latest evaluation scores, and with and you can see which agent needs improvements, which are doing well, which are doing very, very good, very well. I can see the personal trends. I can see, in this case, the relationship between my sales and my efforts evaluation score. I can see a lot of data. And another very interesting interesting part I can see on this dashboard is my average evaluation score and my predictive evaluation score. This score is average evaluation score, is the average score based on all manual evaluations done by my evaluators, by quality managers in the selected period. Of course, very valuable because I can see what is my you can see what is my average score. But what this predictive evaluation score is powered by our analytics tool, because in a typical contact center, you're maybe you can maybe do 2-3% of all your interactions. You could do a manual analytics on it, manual evaluation on it. So that means that 98-97% of all interactions will not be evaluated. And of course, that's a very valuable information stored in all those interactions. So with the predictive evaluation score, you can have our analytics tooling analyze all those non-manual evaluated interactions and have it evaluated automatically and give it a predictive score. So so you can see, okay, this is based on the 2-3% we did manual, but based on our predictive algorithm, this is probably the average if we analyze 100% of your interactions. And of course, you can use this predictive evaluation score to make a selection of interactions you're interested in. For example, if I want to focus on interactions with a very high or very low predictive evaluation score, I can just go back to my recording search and just use my predicted evaluation score, as you can see here, as one of my search criteria, or I put it in one of my contact queue selection rules that I want to focus on calls with a high or low predictive evaluation score. So again, you see, it's adding a lot of additional value. And of course, with our analytics, it's also providing analytics-powered dashboards, like I'm showing right now, with the word clouds, with trends. And of course, it's not only static data, you can drill down to it and drill down all the way to the interaction details. But not only your quality evaluators and your management will benefit from the customizable dashboards. Also, your agents will benefit from it, because you can create personal dashboards for your agents and give them insights in their own personal performance, like I'm showing you right now in this example. In this example, my agent Brian has his own personal dashboard where he can see his five best interactions, his five worst interactions. He can see his multi-week trend in this diagram, and he can see how his performance compared to the performance of his team, direct team members. And you're not only able to see, but you can also dive, do a drill down on those data and dive all up to the contact details, where I can see the score form, maybe the comments the evaluator has added to the evaluation form. He can listen to his own call, so he can see all the details and learn from his own previous calls and to improve his performance. So I think that is, and I want to close this demo with this, and want to I hope I can tell you a lot more about all the quality management part, but I for now I think this covers the main process, the quality management process, and summarized, it will offer you a very powerful recording search feature. You can automated interaction selection for very efficient quality management process and evaluations. Our media player gives you all relevant and all valuable information for your quality evaluator combined in one single view. You can add additional metadata to enrich your interaction data and have an even better context. And with the analytics, optional analytics applied to the system, you'll get even more value in your quality management process by adding voice to text transcriptions, phrase and category detection, and of course powerful dashboards and search options through all your interactions, and not only to the 2%, 3% you can do manually. With this, I would like to end this demonstration. If you have any more questions, I will be happy to make an appointment or a meeting for some deep dives. Or if you have any questions, please send those to me, and I will be happy to respond to those. Thank you for your attention, and I will stop the recording right now.